Namaskar, ma inabarkao. Ma, baudiko pangata baeka balbalika jaruko lagi, kam gari rae kochu. Jamile, barkare International Disabled Day, maneko chau. International Disabled Day ko, aba sharma subakamana dinucha hancho. Danebat. All these are art and handicraft made by our young people with intellectual disabilities. You can see some of our youths are very, very talented. They can paint this kind of art. Also, they can paint face, like you give one picture of you and they can paint exactly same face. We also make pote, topi, earrings, envelopes, and different kind of handicraft.
Yo man ma ti mi chau, iya kha ma ti mi chau. Yo man ma ti mi chau, dekhau na pot garo, dekhau na pot garo. Jeevan ma ti mi chau.
In Barcelona, in Spain. Since the childhood, I always like to support others. And since very small age, I always like social work. I always like to feel like I am contributing to make a better world. I visited Nepal first time in 2012. That time I was 21 years old. After my first trip, my life changed. I was so surprised to know how disabled children are living here, how less facilities they have. Same child with same kind of disability, his life can be completely different if he is born in Spain or if he is born in Nepal. I am this kind of person that if I want something, I will not stop until I achieve this thing. I feel Nepal is the best place in the world. I mean, there is so many things to change. Disabled people were not living good, intellectual disabled children were not having a school. But as a society, as a place, I really feel like Nepal is one of the best places. Nepali people is so welcoming, so good. After 8 months of being in Barcelona collecting funds, I came back to Nepal. To build Asha special school, it was not easy. To be alone, being foreigner and lady, it was really difficult. I struggled so much to build a school, but I always thought it was possible. I never lose hope. I always thought I had to do. Our vision is that young people with disability can work. We believe first we need to provide them training and to make them specialize in something. Like, for example, one kid become perfect in painting, or one young person become perfect in doing cake, or in doing mala, or everyone become perfect in something. And after that, we provide them job opportunities for each of them. This is our dream.
Vatsalya Natural IVF, Adhunik Chikitsa, Uchcha Safalta Dar, Antarashtriya Star Ko Upachar Dwara, Santan Prapti Sambhav Chha.
In Barcelona, in Spain. Barcelona is a big city, like Kathmandu, but it is quite different. It has much more facilities than here. I think life is easier in so many points there. I am a lone daughter in my family. I don't have brothers and sisters. My childhood I remember like very happy. Since the childhood I always like to support others. I remember when I was a teenager, 14 years, 15 years, all my friends always say like I am a psychologist in the group of friends, because I always used to give like my advice to my friends, how they have to do to be better, to don't have problems, to move forward if they had any kind of personal problem. And since very small age, I always like social work. I always like to feel like I am contributing to make better world. I visited Nepal first time in 2012. That time I was 21 years old. I was studying social work in University of Barcelona, and it was my summer vacation between third year and last year of bachelor. And actually, I don't know why I chose Nepal. Maybe it was my destiny to come here. I was sure I wanted to go somewhere and to know more about disabled children, to know what, to collaborate with disabled children. And I find one orphanage, one Valgrija, in Getauda. So I went there. The first time I came to Nepal, my family was okay, because for them it was just a summer vacation. I just came here for 2 months and a half, so they were happy, they were okay. But after my first trip, my life changed. I was so surprised to know how disabled children are living here, how less facilities they have. When I was in Etauda, the children I meet, they didn't have any school to go. Not in Etauda, not in all Makbampur district. So these children were all day at home, only eating, sleeping, not learning anything. And main thing, for everyone that was normal. When I used to talk with people why these children are not going to school, they were telling me, these children are disabled. They cannot learn anything. So, I mean, for everyone it was a normal thing that disabled children were not going to school. I was really surprised, because in that time in Barcelona, I used to work with intellectual disabled children in one school. We had every facility for those kids. And I was just surprised to compare why. Why in Barcelona, in Spain, we have all these facilities and in Nepal there is none. I mean, same child with same kind of disability, his life can be completely different if he is born in Spain or if he is born in Nepal. And that really makes me so much pain here. When I back Barcelona after my summer vacation, I start again my studies, I start again working. And every day when I was at job, I was just thinking how it is possible. If the same child here in Barcelona was not born here, if he born in Nepal, his life is completely different. And that was making me so much pain. And after 15 days of being in Barcelona, I decided I cannot be here. I need to do something, I need to go back to Nepal. Then that when my journey really started. I registered one organization in Spain. On that time, yes, my family was not that much happy, of course. They thought like I am an educated person, I can have a bright future in my country, why to go to Nepal? They were also afraid. One thing is to feel about vacation, to feel about 1 month or 2 months. Next thing is like, I want to go there and start one project. I want to be in Nepal. It is like two different things. That time my family was really scared, but my family always have support me. Like, I am this kind of person that if I want something, I will not stop until I achieve this thing. And my family know that. They knew either they support me, either they don't support me, but I will do this. So they support me. When I return to my place, after 15 days, I decide I need to do something, I need to back Nepal. Then I register one social organization in Spain, okay. And I start collecting money. After 8 months, I back Nepal. During my first visit, I feel Nepal is best place in the world. I mean, there is so many things to change. Disabled people were not living good, intellectual disabled children were not having a school. But as a society, as a place, I really feel like Nepal is one of the best places. Nepali people is so welcoming, so good. Maybe you don't know someone, but they will call you Didi, Baini. They make you feel really like you are at home, like they are family in very short time. Main factor was to compare like why in Nepal there is no special schools, there is no more rights for intellectual disabled children, and in Spain, yes. Not only in Spain, I mean in Europe or in USA or in other parts of the world. To compare this, it was really painful for me. Why here, these same children who they really have capacities, who they could learn, they could develop their skills, when they are young, they could have a job if they are living in other country. Why in Nepal this is not happening? Why in Nepal people believe like they cannot do anything, that they cannot learn, that only they can be closed inside home? I have seen children like closed. I have been children with Dory here all day at home. And I feel this is not fair. I feel these children, I mean, they have same rights. Not because they are born here, they cannot learn. I feel they should, every child is equal, no matter in what place of the world they are born. After 8 months of being in Barcelona collecting funds, I came back to Nepal. To build Asha special school, it was not easy. To be alone, being foreigner and lady, it was really difficult. I struggled so much to build a school, but I always thought it was possible. I never lose hope. I always thought I had to do. I always feel if I give up, no one was going to stand up for these children. So I thought whatever it is difficult for me, I need to make it happen because these children deserve it. And we were 4 months fighting quite a lot with everyone in Etauda, and at last we could build Asha School. At the beginning, we have 18 children. Our education system, it is we take some kind of system that in Europe schools they have. We work with individual objective for every children because every child is different in a special education. There is not 2 children who are same. And we build different individual objective for each one. And also we teach like different kind of subjects, like academic subjects, daily activities of daily life, instrumental activities, and all the things that they need to learn to have independent life and to have autonomy to live. Actually, at the beginning, I was alone. I say we because way of talking, but I was alone at the beginning. 2 months after I reached, I put advertisement in newspaper, and we had the first 3 staff, 2 teachers and 1 physiotherapist. After 2 months, 3 staff joined the team. Who was physiotherapist now is our country director, Rupa Karki. And who was teacher, now she is our academic coordinator, Shanti Chavlagain. And since I started having team, of course, things were little easy. I always work with women. All our staff are women, because I feel maybe not at all in Kathmandu, but in many parts of Nepal, women are very discriminated. And I feel they also, if I can give one opportunity as a woman, here in Nepal I have faced so much what means patriarchal society. I have faced it so much. So if as a woman I can give opportunity to other women to work, to be empowered, to grow, so of course I will do that. Now total we have 27 ladies working with us in Etauda and Kathmandu, and they are great. They are mothers at home, but they are also mothers at the school. I have faced discrimination to be foreigner. I have listened you go back to your country so many times. I have faced discrimination for being a woman. Like, so many sirs will not give same respect to you if you are a young lady or if you come from some political background or if you have some political support. And that time I was completely alone. Even I didn't know about Nepal, how Nepal works. Only I knew I want to do one school for intellectual disabled children. That was only thing I knew in that time. Every day, whenever I see children, like they say, "Mi namaste, mis," I feel they are so innocent. If I don't keep on working for their education, no one is going to do that. I never feel to give up, but I had some days like maybe I was little sad. Actually, I was 21 years old. If you compare that time, the life of my friends, they were just enjoying life, going for shopping, going for coffee. They didn't have any kind of worry or stress, just they were living the life. And my life was supposed to be like that. And I faced situations that I never thought it would happen to me. And even in my worst imagination, I never thought I would face this kind of situations. So, of course, there were days that I could be sad, I could be in a stress, but whenever I saw children, I feel I cannot go. I need to be here. I cannot leave them because they have no voice. They cannot express what they need, what they want. So they cannot also express we need education and education is our right. Many times their families don't know how to protect the child, how to stand up for their child. So I never thought on living at all. Even in the worst moments, I always try to be positive by thinking, okay, tomorrow it will be better. Okay, tomorrow we will achieve. And usually every night I used to make myself feel, okay, tomorrow we will make that thing, that issue settle or that thing happen. Parents got convinced quite fast. Even at times I would love to speak Nepali that time, so I could explain more things to families and and share more with families and explain why it's important families get, children get education. Luckily, the team I had, the teachers I had, they used to translate me. I used to speak them in English and they used to translate in Nepali. And families got, it was not hard to convince. They understood and they thought, okay, we will try. I always told them, okay, you try 3 months. Not necessarily you believe us, only you try 3 months. If your child can change, if your child can improve, you try 3 months. If you are not happy, if your child cannot improve, okay, you keep your child at home, we will not say anything. And usually families try, and in 3 months, every child do big change. Maybe someone could not eat alone, and then when you give a spoon, they used to throw. Later, you give a spoon and they were eating alone after 3 months. Or maybe some children didn't know how to write, and after 3 months, at least they write one letter or 2 letters. And every child in his capacities, they improve quite a lot. In Etauda, we have currently about 50 children. We have 4 classrooms, A, B, C, D, 4 levels. A level is who have more capacities, who is more talent. And D level is who have more difficulties to learn. And also we have physiotherapy room. And we have vocational training also. We have 2 classrooms of vocational training. So total we have 6 classrooms. And we have 9 teachers. And cook, security guard. And we have bus. We have also 1 hostel. Hostel is very small, it is on rent. And now we are working to build a bigger hostel for our children and also to welcome new children. We have about more than 100 children in waiting list. Mainly they are from rural areas and it is not possible for them to come every day. Our bus also cannot reach these areas because it's too much far. So those families want to, during the school time, to put child in the hostel. And we are working to build a bigger hostel in Etauda. To manage funds for the project, it was never easy. Actually, to convince Spanish people to support in Nepal is not easy. There is many people who even don't know where is Nepal, and everyone have own problems, no? So I need to convince them, okay, please, you collaborate in other country. There is more problems than our problems, and it is quite hard to do that. Anyway, we start collecting some funds with the Spanish community. And here in Nepal at the beginning, it was really hard. There is one kind of misconception that BDC people have so much money. And usually it was also hard to make people here value, like the money that comes from Spain is not easy for me. So please let's value that. Let's use each rupee in a proper way and let's use it everything for the children because it is so hard to get it. And at the beginning, it was hard to get fund collection from Nepal because I was alone. After I got married with Kaila Sher, we registered CIASHA Foundation, and it's been much more easy. to explain our work to Nepali community and to also start having support from the Nepali community. From 2013 to 2016, all from Spain, nothing from Nepal. From 2016, NRNA, they support us. And NRN and all NRN community, they start providing support from different, mainly from Spain, but also from different countries of Europe. I was also in Denmark in one annual program of NRNA, and different personalities there, they support to buy a school bus in Etauda. And after that, also in Etauda, little bit people changed the way they start treating me. And some local clubs like Lions Club, Rotary Club, or Leo Club, these kind of clubs, they also start supporting time to time, like maybe they were providing rice, or they were providing stationery, or they were providing some materials for us. In Nepal, for foreigners, it's very hard to stay. Visa is a very big problem for every foreigner who wants to stay here. And also I faced that problem. I could not do much. I was here as a tourist, I could not do much. I could not be many months. I was 5 months per year or 6 months per year, not more than that. I stay some time, collect money, come again, like that. I tried to convince people. Also, I was doing some programs, like, for example, some concert or some different kind of programs. Some musical show or different kind of programs, and people also come and give some donation money. Also some organizations, foundations from Spain also they like to support, and that way. One of the challenges was with government. As I was not from here also, I didn't know what is the way to approach, what is the way to go, and we were 3 years fighting to register a school. After 3 years, we could register successfully. And it was difficult in every aspect, like to make people convince, government people convincing Etauda that special education was necessary and that intellectual disabled children also need school. Now everything is fine. I mean, we have the support from Etauda Nagarpalika and all different government offices. But at the beginning, it was a little complicated. Yeah, at the beginning, my family was a little worried because I am a lone daughter and they expect I will be with them and I will be in my country. But now my family is happy. They are very proud. They also visit here sometimes and they are very happy that I am here. They don't say anything, only they feel this is your life, you choose what you want, and we are very happy to support. I don't know how to describe myself in one word. I put different identities because I don't know how to describe in only one word. I mean, I do social work in Nepal and this is my passion, my dream, like my life purpose. I feel to be here and to work for disabled people. I also love to teach since four years, I'm teaching in the University of Barcelona. I am co-director of one postgraduate course of social entrepreneurship and leadership. And also I love to write. Since the very childhood, I always thought I will be a writer. When I came to Nepal, I faced so much stress and I didn't find the place, the time to start writing. But on 2018, I write one book. It is called Asha or the Power of Hope. Right now it's only in a Spanish language, but I'm working to publish very soon in English language also. And I explain all my stories since 2012 when I came here first time up to 2018. In that book, the different struggles I face here by being alone and how it was to establish Asha Special School. I don't believe that much in nationality. I feel like everyone is human. And I don't believe like I am Spanish or you are Nepali or that is whatever Japanese. And I marry with Kailash Nopane because I love him and I don't mind he is Nepali or he is from where, only because of I love him, I marry with him, only that reason. In so many things, I feel myself more cultural than my husband. I am not Nepali, but in so many things I am more Nepali than him. In so many things he is much more international than me. All the problems I had by being foreigner, all this disappear. Now, no one can say me like you are a foreigner, because after all I'm Nepali Buhari and I can reply them that way. This is from one side. Other side, like before time, maybe so many people were trying to take advantage because they feel I was alone. They feel no one will go there to tell them anything. And now if someone want to take advantage, first they will feel, okay, if I do something to Aina, I am doing something to her family, no? First they will feel, okay, what is Aina's husband background? Then they will think and they will decide, I want to fight with Aina's husband or I don't want to fight with him. Then first they will think, I want to go against her or I don't want to go against her. Before time it was very easy. Whoever wanted to take advantage, I didn't have any background. I didn't have any family who was really there to support me, to fight for me if something was not going well. And after all, Nepal works like that. Like, family support is very important in Nepal. Actually, this sindur, most probably if I was married Nepali, I was not wearing. Because itself, I feel it is little patriarchal. Because women need to show they are married, but men are not showing they are married. So I feel it in some point, it is little Purush Pradhan. But as a foreigner, for me, it's like one kind of protection. Like every day I wear it and I feel, okay, I am not foreigner. I am from here. If you do bad to me, I also have one family here. You cannot treat me bad. It gives me one kind of empower, and that's why I always wear. I feel like one kind of protection. I can maybe explain about, like, we want to do school in Seven Pradesh. In Kathmandu, we start vocational training just 8 months ago, little before last lockdown. And now we are opening a school also for little children. And our dream is by 2030 to have one school in every province. In province 3, we are already in Hetauda and in Kathmandu. But we want to be in each province of Nepal. Now we are starting in Bardivas in province 2. We are under construction with the support of government, province government and Nagarpalika also. And we are planning after that to go to other province, maybe province 4, or we are just studying and in collaboration with government. Our dream is by 2030 to be in every province. Our school fee is 125 rupees per month. And this is just like symbolic. With 125 rupees, honestly, we cannot run the school. Even we cannot pay one single teacher if we collect all the fees of all our students. We cannot run the bus, we cannot do much with this money, but it is to make families put some value in the school. If things are completely free, maybe they don't put value on that. If it is free, you feel, okay, it is free. I don't know if my child come, okay, if my child is not coming, is also okay. So we want family feel a school is important. So that's why we put fee of 125 rupees. If some family have economical problems, they are not paying. We give a scholarship and they are not paying anything. And if some family really wish to help and they want to do some donation also, they are welcome to contribute and to donate whatever they can, whatever they want. At morning time, children do PT. And after that, they do academic activities. We teach them like normal schools. We teach them Nepali, maths, English, social natural science. After that, they do copy. They learn how to write in Nepali and in English both. And after that, they do other activities, like, for example, basic activities of daily life. Some children, for example, don't know how to clean their face properly or how to put the buttons of the clothes properly. Or they learn, okay, in winter time we need to wear warm clothes, in summer time no. They also learn instrumental activities, how to talk with society, how to call in phone. Then in vocational training, they learn different kind of handicraft, like pote, mala, topi, painting. And they also do envelopes, candle, cake, cooking, and different kind of activities. Our vision is that young people with disability can work. We believe first we need to provide them training and to make them specialize in something. Like, for example, one kid become perfect in painting, or one young person become perfect in doing cake or in doing mala, or everyone become perfect in something. And after that, we provide them job opportunities for each of them. This is our dream.
Namaste, mera naam Shanti Chalogai. म एउटा विशेष आशा विशेष पाठशाला तथा पुनर्स्थापना केन्द्रको विशेष फर्स्ट टाइममा विशेष शिक्षिकाको रूपमा काम गर्दै आएको थिएँ भने अहिले मैले विद्यालय स्पेसल एजुकेसन कोअर्डिनेटरको रूपमा काम गर्दै आइरहेको छु र अहिले मैले त्यसै क्रममा काठमाडौँमा पनि हाम्रो आशा भोकेसनल ट्रेनिङ सेन्टर स्थापना भएको छ र त्यसमा पनि मैले टिचरहरूलाई स्पेसल एजुकेसन ट्रेनिङहरू दिँदै आइरहेको छु र यसरी हाम्रो आइना म्यामसँग सम्बन्धित भएर सामाजिक कार्य गर्दै अगाडि बढिरहेको छु. आइना म्यामले चाहिँ नेपालमा भिजिट गर्नका लागि आउनुभएको थियो, भोलिन्टियरको रूपमा काम गर्नका लागि नेपाल आउनुभएको थियो. उहाँ दुई महिना ट्रेनिङको लागि भनेर आउनुभएको थियो भोलिन्टियरको लागि र उहाँले चाहिँ देख्नुभएछ नेपालमा हाम्रो बौद्धिक अपाङ्गता भाइ बहिनीहरूको विचलित हुन्छ नि उहाँहरूको अवस्था देखेर चाहिँ उहाँले प्लानिङ गर्नुभएछ. मैले चाहिँ नेपालमा पनि एउटा स्पेसल एजुकेसन सेन्टर खोल्न पाएदेखि यी भाइ बहिनीहरूका लागि मैले ट्रेनिङ दिन सक्छु भन्ने उहाँहरूको उद्देश्य हुनुहुन्थ्यो र त्यो उद्देश्यलाई पुरा गर्नका लागि उहाँले चाहिँ विद्यालय हुन्छ एउटा मर्चमा हुन्छ नि विद्यालयले चाहिँ सहयोग गरेर थोरै ल्यान्ड दिएर चाहिँ एउटा स्पेसल एजुकेसन सेन्टर हामीले पनि खोल्न पाएदेखि हुन्थ्यो भन्ने उद्देश्यले हेटौँडामा खोजिरहनु भएको थियो र त्यो अवस्थामा उहाँसँग चिनजान चाहिँ भ्याकेन्सी आउट भएको थियो. फर्स्ट टाइममा चिनजान भएको चाहिँ भ्याकेन्सी आउट गर्नुभएको थियो र त्यसमा मैले एउटा सन्देशमा देखेको थिएँ र म उहाँ फर्म भर्न पहिलोचोटि गएको थिएँ. त्यो अवस्थाबाट चाहिँ उहाँसँग मेरो पहिलो चिनजान भएको थियो र यो उद्देश्यलाई सुरुमा सक्सेस गराउनलाई चाहिँ जस्तो हाम्रो सोचाइ छ नि समाजको सोचाइलाई यो बौद्धिक क्षमता कमजोर भएको भाइ बहिनीहरूले चाहिँ केही पनि गर्न सक्नुहुन्न भन्ने सोचाइलाई चाहिँ हामीले परिवर्तन गर्दै र उहाँसँग पहिलो भेट त्यो अवस्थामा भएर त्यसलाई त्यो सोचाइलाई चाहिँ हामीले परिवर्तन गराउँदै अगाडि बढ्दै आइरहेका छौँ. अहिले पनि हाम्रो अहिले 47 भाइ बहिनीहरू रेगुलर क्लास लिइरहनु भएको छ र 125-30 भाइ बहिनीहरू चाहिँ हाम्रो वेटिङमा हुनुहुन्छ. उहाँहरूलाई हामीले भनेको जस्तो हामीसँग बिल्डिङको अभाव भएको कारणले गर्दाखेरि उहाँहरूलाई सही लिएर आउनका लागि पोसिबल भएको छैन.
नमस्कार, मेरो नाम इन्दिरा बस्नेत हो. म चाहिँ जौलाहिलमा बस्छु. म यस स्कुलमा सानसाना भाइ बहिनीहरूलाई लिएर आउने र उहाँहरूको घर पुर्याउने काम गर्दछु. म चाहिँ बिहान 7 बजेदेखि नै 7 बजेको ठ्याक्कै बस स्ट्यान्डमा बस्छु, आएर बस्छु. त्यहाँबाट हाम्रो स्कुलको गाडी आउँछ. त्यहाँबाट म अब स्कुलमा ल्याउनको लागि बिहान 7 बजेदेखि भाइ बहिनी लिनलाई उहाँहरूको घरमा जान्छु. हाम्रो भाइ बहिनीहरू सबै ज्ञानी त हुनुहुन्छ, कसैलाई चाहिँ बस चढ्नलाई गाह्रो हुन्छ. उहाँहरूलाई मैले समातेर बिस्तारै हेल्प गरेर माथि चढाउँछु. अनि कोही अलि मोटो हुनुहुन्छ हेबी, उहाँहरूको ज्यान आफैलाई नै भारी भइरहेको हुन्छ. उहाँहरूलाई समातेर बिस्तारै राखेर अनि ओह्राल्ने उकाल्ने काम गर्छु. अनि 9 बजे आएपछि स्कुलमा उहाँहरूलाई चिया नास्ताको व्यवस्था हुन्छ. अनि चियाहरू खुवाएर बिस्कुट खुवाएर एसेम्ब्लीको लागि तल लिएर आउँछौँ. अनि त्यसपछि मेरो उहाँहरू क्लासमा जानुभएपछि मेरो किचनमा काम सुरु हुन्छ. उहाँहरूलाई खानाहरूको लागि तरकारीहरू बनाउने, खाना बनाउने. अनि 12 बजेपछि उहाँहरूको खाना खाने टाइम हुन्छ. उहाँहरूलाई खाना खानालाई हेल्प गर्ने. अनिहरू खानासाना खाएर क्लासमा जानुहुन्छ. अनि बाँकी किचनको बाहिरको कामहरू सिधाएर हाम्रो 3:15 छुट्टी हुन्छ. त्यसपछि सबै भाइ बहिनीलाई मैले समटेर उहाँहरूको घर घरमा पुऱ्याएर बेलुका त्यस्तै 6:30-7 बजेसम्म घर पुग्दा.
नमस्कार, मेरो नाम चाहिँ सीता जिरेल हो. म चाहिँ 1 वर्ष अगाडि यो काई ग्रुपमा काम गर्थेँ अफिसमा. अनि यहाँ आएको चाहिँ यहाँ जोइन भएको चाहिँ 1 हप्ता हुन लाग्यो. अनि यहाँ आएर म यही भाइ बहिनीहरूलाई हेरविचार गर्ने, खानाहरू खाजा बनाएर दिने, हाम्रो बाबुहरूलाई दिए जस्तै लाग्छ. त्यस्तै
नानी चाहिँ अरु हेर्दाखेरि त नर्मलै जस्तो देखिन्छ तर उसको अलिकति समस्या नै पढ्न नसक्ने हजुर अब एबिसिडी क ख ग ग अब 22 वर्षको पुरा भइसक्यो नानी तर एबिसिडी क ख ग ग मात्रै भन्छे अनि अब त्यही नर्मलहरू मात्रै भनि अरु देख्दाखेरि चाहिँ सबै कुराहरू गर्ने हो नि सबैमा चाहिँ एक्टिभै छ तर पढाइमा चाहिँ कमजोरी सोध्दै खोज्दै 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 आएर भेटेको मैले फोन गर्दै गर्दै आएर भेटेको नर्मल स्कुलमा पनि राखेको थियो सर राख्न चाहिँ अब बाबु छ ऊ भन्दा मुनिको अनि ऊ चाहिँ राम्रो क्लास टप्दै गयो अनि नानी चाहिँ नसक्ने नै रहेछ भनेर चाहिँ हामीले यस्तै बच्चाहरूको स्कुलमा राखिदिएको दुई तिनवटा स्कुलमा राखिदिइसक्यौँ तौल पनि कम थियो हजुर अँ सानै छ हजुर मान्छे हेर्दाखेरि त देख्दा त नर्मलै जस्तो कसैले पनि त्यस्तो बुझ्दैन नानीको जिउ डाल यताउति हेर्दा चाहिँ मान्छे चाहिँ जे होस् 15-16 वर्षको जस्तो छ कि 22 वर्षको मान्छे सानी अस्ति चाहिँ लिएर आएको थिएँ मैले अब आज चाहिँ लिएर आइनँ पर्सि आइतबारदेखि लिएर आउँछु भनेर अनि त्यहाँबाट नलिएर आएको आज चाहिँ
आँखामा तिमी छौ यो मनमा तिमी छौ आँखामा तिमी छौ यो मनमा तिमी छौ देखाउन बहुत गाह्रो देखाउन बहुत गाह्रो जीवनमा तिमी छौ तिमी भएर मात्रै जिन्दगीमा मजा छ जिन्दगीमा मजा छ देखाउन बहुत गाह्रो देखाउन बहुत गाह्रो जीवनमा तिमी छौ तिमी भएर मात्रै जिन्दगीमा मजा छ फेरि कहाँ आउँछ रे गो मेरा यो बालपनको उमेर केही छैन चिन्ता केही छैन पीरा खुला काँसको पन्चे जस्तै घुम्छु चारैतिर सबैकी प्यारी मान्छे म सबैकी आँखा कि नानी कसलाई मन पर्दैन र मेरो आनी बानी फेरि कहाँ आउँछ गो मेरो यो बालपनको उमेर ¶¶